Looking back at Tesla, you can see ever since it booked the 248, had a rough time. And I was basically looking at this 178, come down to this 178 for support, because you look at here, so basically got have established some fairly long-term support here quite a few times back at a couple years ago. So essentially when it came down to that 178, that would be a nice area to look for possible long setup and play it back up at least a bounce to the 216 area, because that 216 has also got a lot of nice chop zone here. You know, price here that's got chopping around. So we'll be keeping an eye on that 216 right now, and gonna be watching to see would it be able to continue to move up. And looking at the daily, you can see on the daily, sort of got a little bit of a shooting star here on Friday. And you know, the Thursday candle was a little bit of a spinning top, so that could be a sign of maybe a near-term exhaustion, and maybe it could come down and fill this little gap here before trying to make a push to the 216. If it push above the 216, that'd be watching for this particular trend line, and that would be somewhere around the 235 area. But if it could not push up to the 316, come back down, fill this gap, then I'd be looking for a retest of the 178. So if we take a look at the 60-minute chart here, and this is basically the gap that I'm talking about. If it come down and fill this gap, then there's a good possibility that it could come down to that 178. But if it hold above this gap and basically chop around and move up to the 316 here, and if it could stay above that 316, then basically looking for this trend line for that 235. So that is basically my watch on the Tesla. And if you like the content in this video, give it a thumbs up. If you're not a subscriber of my YouTube channel, click the subscribe button and the notification icon to avoid missing any future video. Good luck.